You know, life is filled with mountaintop experiences and, unfortunately, valley experiences. It's just the way of life here on Earth. Another reason we are waiting impatiently for the second coming of Christ. But in the meantime, we have to deal with life as it exists here on Earth. And there will be times in your parenting, times in your marriage, times at work where you're just frustrated. And maybe you're in one of those seasons where you're just feeling discouraged. And maybe even deeper than discouragement, maybe you're just feeling weary. Have you ever felt that like soul deep weariness, that bone deep weariness? And it isn't so much because you haven't got enough sleep at night, although that could be one of the reasons, but it's like just that soul deep weariness, exhaustion, just kind of tired of having to keep on trying in whatever avenue, you know, your marriage, your parenting, whatever. Well, this might sound like a rather strange remedy, but something that will truly refresh and revive and rejuvenate your soul is meditating on God's Word. Truly, when you actually spend time just sort of soaking up God's Word, His promises, when you start reading story after story after story in the Bible where things seemed hopeless and then God came on the scene, it starts to bring back your hope. It starts to rejuvenate your soul. You start to be able to persevere through that current situation. I know this is true because the Bible says that the Word of God refreshes your soul. Listen to what Psalm 19 says, starting in verse 7. The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The statutes of the Lord are trustworthy, making wise the simple. The precepts of the Lord are right, giving joy to the heart. The commands of the Lord are radiant, giving light to the eyes. Yes, the more time you spend reading God's Word, His commands, His instructions, you'll find your soul being refreshed. You'll find your joy returning. You'll find yourself growing more wise. Wouldn't you want a little bit of that? And as you dig into God's Word, for instance, if you're struggling in your marriage, you'll probably stumble across something that I stumbled across when I was having trouble in my marriage, Matthew 18. Read it for yourself. Matthew 18, starting in verse 15, God gives us instructions on what to do if someone in close relationship with you is sinning against you. He tells you right there in Matthew 18. You might want to read that for yourself. That could make you wise in your situation where you've grown weary. Or maybe you're growing weary in parenting this rebellious teen or this stubborn four-year-old or whatnot, right? Well, maybe you could dwell on Proverbs 13, verse 24. I won't read it right now. You read it for yourself. Proverbs 13, verse 24. Again, digging into God's Word, it will refresh your soul.